Hey guys, welcome back to some more Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Last time, in our path to leave the Titan battleship, we encountered what's his name again? That weird French dude. Yeah. We had an encounter, a little fight, and now it is time for us to leave. Before we do that, I'm just gonna recheck everything. Ooh, you see? Make sure I have... Okay, here we go. I'll do that. No, I don't need engage blades. Affinity... No. Let me check that. Okay. We received a pouch expansion. Everyone here has one pouch. However, we now have the option to expand, but we can only do it once. So, for this case, I am going to give it to Rex. Now, he has two. But that's not all. We can yet use another. So, I will then use my last one on Neo, because we don't have two. I thought the reason why I thought we had two is because at the bottom it still said expand, and I thought, you know, why would they give me that option if I didn't have it? So that was my reasoning. So yeah, now we can equip two items, which is all very good. Now, we should probably stop gawking and get walking. Because this leads directly outside, yeah. Just one big look, right where we were. I keep stumbling up in my words. I'm not sure why, because I just recorded the last episode and I did pretty good with it, so I... Who knows? I'm gonna give Rex some... I'll give you the Nopon chest seat. There we go. Maybe it's just because I'm tired. Maybe that's why I'm stumbling on my words. Anyway, there's the exit.
These flames again!
It's her!
Driver too this time.
That's Morag, the flame bringer.
Morag?
Special Inquisitor Morag of Morag A, the most powerful driver in the Empire, and wielder of Bridget, the most powerful blade.
So together they're like ultra powerful.
It looks like they were waiting for us.
Yes, indeed. I did feel like we got away a little too easily.
I don't know why I expected Dougal to slow you down at all.
Dougal was the name I was talking about in the intro. Oops.
Just to lure Rex and the others here.
You catch on quickly. Yes. You certainly proved useful. However,
Rex and Pyra at the real price.
Not quite. The Emerald Core Crystal is the sign of the Aegis. If that blade is indeed the Aegis, then there's something I must do.
What do you mean?
The power to sunder all rest itself. I cannot allow that to happen again.
Pyra destroyed the world. Don't be so stupid.
You mean you didn't know? 500 years ago, during the Aegis War, the Aegis sank three continents to the Cloud Sea's bed.
Three Titans destroyed?
I speak not but historical fact.
I'm on to you. You want to use Pyra as some kind of weapon? We're not going to let you do that.
That is precisely the kind of scenario that I mean to prevent.
And what if we resist?
Then I will have to restrain you by force.
In that case, I'll make this nice and clear. You will never take her!
Then let's see if you have the strength to back up those words, boy.
Dougal is just the appetizer. This is Morag, the Flamebringer. Starting off, the first thing you want to do is make sure everyone is aggroing Morag. She is the most powerful driver, accompanied with the most second powerful blade. Second because I have the first. This is basically kind of like the same fight with Dougal, except one thing you will notice right away is Morag isn't as mobile. She can move, but she doesn't move. Which is nice. That gives you more of an opportunity to move around. So the same strategy applies. Oh, she went after me. Okay, I want her at Toro. I'm not gonna get a second one, oh well. I'm gonna be Tor again because then. Oh, I think he got it off. He did get it off, okay. I'm going to give this one time. And the reason why I'm gonna wait is because the only other blade that I can use is either Sagnar or Tora's Pop. If I use my second, Tora's will pop. Oh, yep, I know about level 4 specials. If I use my second. Actually, let's just use a level 4 right now. Burning Sword! The most powerful one that we can do. Definitely took a lot out of her. Anyway, with that, now hopefully Tora will be able to get level 3. That is goal at least. I got my finger hovering right over ZR just so I can press it right when I have it. I could use a chain attack right now, but there it is. Mega Eruption. And that's what I'm talking about.
Stay vigilant, Morag. An unknown power. what's within this bowl. But of course, this blade he calls Pyra. Your flames burn far stronger than ours. But our flames hide something deeper.
Is everyone all right?
Honey, Lindley.
Those two, very strong.
I know. At this rate, we'll never. There has to be a way. Some kind of. She's a fireplace. We've got to find water. There. Guys, are you ready to run? Sure. Then follow me.
Slighted. How so? They actually held back against me in battle. You think that boy, did you not see? He could have struck me with that blow, but he averted his aim. He did have good instincts too.
And I'm gonna help her. I'm not going to let you stand in her way.
The Aegis. If she is traveling with that boy, perhaps it is worth letting him roam free for a while. You mean, we'll cross paths again. And when we do, we shall see.
We're safe for now.
You're right. We should get some rest. I can't go any further.
Ah, Tomorrow is pooped as well.
See you later.
Huh? We are grateful for all you've done. We wish you well on your travels. Farewell.
I want to reach Elysium.
What?
I made a promise. I'm taking Pyra to Elysium. It's just... she gave half of her life to save mine. I owe her.
Oh, X.
But half the world seems to be after her. With the Titans dying off, living space is running out. That's gonna start wars. And people need weapons to fight wars. That's why they want her. If I can prove Elysium exists, maybe I can stop the war that's coming. But fighting Mora taught me something. I'm not strong enough. I can't do this alone. Nia, you're a driver. We could really use a companion like you. If you wanted.
Elysium, do you really believe that myth, kid?
Well, Pyra told me that she was born there. Yet here she is. So it must exist. Right?
Your logic is almost as good as Torgul's. Listen, Max. I don't know if you're stupid or just too nice for your own good. But what if Pyra's just lying? What if this is all an act, and one day she turns round and stabs you in the back?
Pyra wouldn't do that.
Of course I wouldn't. I don't have a knife. So... serious. An emerald core crystal is a sign of the ages, huh?
Sure, why not? This could be interesting.
Really?
My lady?
I kinda wanna see this Elysium for myself now. Maybe it really does exist.
It does.
An endless field of green among the clouds, huh? If the legends are true, even people like me.
Swing it like this, and it doesn't even...
I knew it.
Thanks. I feel much better now.
I'm sure that's me as poultice doing its job. Thanks.
Hi, Ram. You hurt too. Are you okay?
I'm fine. It's just a scratch.
Hey, let me help.
Thank you, Rex.
No worries. Least I can do. There, all done. How's that?
Looks good. Rex? Look, they're the same.
Oh. Yeah? I guess they are. Because you made it, Pyra. No. What? I didn't mean it like that. You're just, really good at making fires. That's all.
It's what I do.
I hear the Aegis awakened. Nasty shock for you, or was it? Of course, my script showed how everything would play out from the start.
Sure, you say that once it's all over and done with. It's easy to act smug when hindsight's on your side.
Shut your mouth, Avrona.
I'm shaking to my core.
Where are the other two?
Mikhail's inspecting the Ardanian factory. And my beloved sister is out hunting, as always. I'm sure she'll have found plenty of drivers to chew up and spit out by now.
She likes to hunt, all right. Not sure we can use all of those core crystals, though.
Do we know where the Aegis is right now?
Have no fear, Jin. Of course we know her whereabouts. Abrona?
Yeah.
It seems they're currently traveling away from the urban area of Gormont.
Leaving the town? But there's nothing out that way.
Perhaps they're on their way out of Gormont itself. Oh, and...
What?
It seems a certain shipment has set out.
The core crystals heading to Indol for cleansing, huh? How pious of them. Shall we handle them?
I can deal with that myself. You concentrate on the Aegis.
Understood. Well, I am looking forward to clapping eyes on the Aegis. By the way, what of Nia?
You know where she is?
Yes. Look, this dot here. Without a doubt, this is Dromark's wavelength. It seems they're traveling together with the Aegis.
With the Aegis? Do as you see fit.
Understood. You don't need to ask me twice.
Right then. We're gonna take the Monoceros.
As you wish.
Hey. Don't do anything too reckless.
Sea compass. A must-have for salvagers. It's sort of a map of the Cloud Sea. If you do this, and this... What's the date today?
Amathotober 5th, 4058.
Okay. So now we put the date in. See?
Oh, this is very clever.
Looks like Gormont is the closest country to the World Dream right now.
All we need is a ship.
The army has every ship in town in its grip.
We're kind of stuck. Seems that way.
Sorry, I'm no use now.
I know. But I'm all out of ideas.
Rex needs ship? Tor, I have a good idea!
You do?
There is a shipbuilder living at Gormont Titan's Bum-Bum. Old friend of Tora's Grampy One, he called Umon. Maybe he'd help if we tell him what's what.
Sure, it's worth a shot. Let's get going.
Hey, Tora, the place where this Umon guy lives isn't affected by the Cloud Sea tides, is it? Why Rex ask? Well, I noticed the Cloud Sea's been pretty low ever since we went off to save Nia. It's still low right now, right? Thank you, beeping. I was worrying that depending on the situation, we might be forced to find a different route. Rex has a point. The Cloud Sea tides can have marked effects on the areas you are able to traverse. Sometimes the Cloud Sea may allow you to swim to places that were once out of reach, but equally it can submerge previous reachable areas, halting your progress. Exactly, so I was wondering whether we need to worry about any of that where we're going now.
That makes sense. But is no problem. Path the shipyard of Umon not affected by Cloud Sea at all.
That's good to know. If it was somewhere we could only reach at high tide, we'd have to rest up until the Cloud Sea rises. That doesn't sound so bad to me. Frankly, I'd welcome a well-earned rest at the inn while we wait for the tide to change. No offense, Rex, but your helmet isn't always the most comfortable abode. Yeah, yeah, you can always have a stretch and lie down next time we visit the inn in Torigoth. For now, though, we should go to Shipyard of Uma.